Sound is insanely important. The saying goes that sound's over half of the picture. I think that's pretty much an understatement. Sound is probably the most important thing on a film set. Despite our professed love for cameras, lenses, lights, and all the awesome trappings of the visual stuff that we can buy, without quality sound, we will not be able to deliver professional work. Because the crazy thing is, you can get away with having very poor lenses, average lenses, poor camera, average camera, no lighting at all. But if you actually have a half-decent sound setup, bizarrely, the results will actually still be okay. The crazy thing is it doesn't work the other way around. You cannot get away with having poor sound and spend the rest of your budget on the visual side. It just doesn't work. Let me show you why. Okay, now for a camera using an iPhone 5 on a stack of books, and we have no dedicated lighting source at all, save our local star. For audio, however, I'm using a RØDE VideoMic Pro on a tripod, just slightly out of shot, and I'm running it into the side of our 550D, which I'm just basically using as an audio recorder. Okay, so I've got a expensive, over £500 wide-angle lens on my camera, and I've got a two-panel LED lighting kit either side of me, which collectively also cost over £500. Added with the cost of the camera, the cost of the visual equipment is about £1,500. Of course, we're not using a dedicated audio solution at all. I'm just using the Canon's inbuilt audio at its default setting. Despite the cost of all the visual kit, do you think this would be okay to deliver professionally? And this is with an iPhone 5 as a camera, but we are using a dedicated audio solution. Do you see what I mean? But sound is one of the cheapest things to invest in and easy to set up. But if you don't do it, all the lights and lenses in the world won't help you. Okay, sound is important, we get it. What can we actually do? Well, we need to buy ourselves a microphone. So, our friends at RØDE Microphones have been at the forefront of producing a range of mics called video mics for a number of years now. Video mics have become insanely popular and with very, very good reason. They're astonishingly easy to use. The whole idea is that a video mic just plugs straight into the side of your camera. So you don't need to buy another preamp or any other equipment. You just need to buy the video mic to get massively improved sound over the built-in sound in our camera. And the built-in sound in our camera is almost uniformly completely unacceptable. You cannot use it. The camera is not selective. It's going to pick up sound in all directions. It is not professional sound. It's going to be hissy and noisy. So by buying a video mic, you instantly improve the sound that's in the camera. However, there are a number of techniques that we need to apply. There's some tips that we need to know about in order to get the best from video mics. So what we're going to do is we're going to go through the whole range. We're going to look at them all. We're going to see what their relative strengths are, try and find the best one for you, and we'll also try and learn some tips so that we can get the best from them. So there are two different families of video mic. We have mono video mics and we have stereo video mics. And you might ask yourself the question, should I get a mono or a stereo mic? We get asked that a lot. And the answer is it depends what you want to film. So if you're filming speech, be it interviews, literally like this, a person speaking to the camera, anywhere where we've got someone speaking, you want to be using a mono mic, because a mono mic aims to reject a lot of the unwanted sound that's occurring while you're filming. It's quite selective so that the thing that you're pointing at gets picked up with less of what's going on around you. And that's really important if you're trying to capture clean and usable dialogue on a day. So for speech, go mono. However, if you are filming in nature, if you're filming, documentaries where it's very important that we have a true sense of the environment, you know, in a forest or something with the sound of crickets and birds and just a true sense of space, a stereo mic literally is capturing two channels, just like our ears, so that we hear the kind of the true position of objects that you know, you would be pointing at. And it gives us a feeling of space in the environment. And certainly for so many different situations where I would want to use a stereo mic. So for speech, use mono. For ambience, nature, music, things like this, where space is important and we need to have a spread, stereo. The mono video mics are
directional. So we discussed that they do pick up sound in a focused way and kind of reject ambient sound, but they're not a magic bullet. They don't grab sound and bring it closer to the microphone, because no microphone can do that. They're just being selective about the sound that they do receive. The most important thing that you can possibly do when you're picking up speech with a mono microphone is get the mic as close as you possibly can to the speaking subject. Without pretty much any exception, you will get a better sound with the mic closer to the person. So in this instance, I have a VideoMic Pro just down here out of shot. I tried a few different positions and it's about 4 feet away from me just down here. What I'll do is I'll move it to where the camera is and you can hear what the difference is. Okay, so it's now about 10 feet away from me because I'm using a 50mm lens and that's how it sounds. How's that for you? Is that working out quite well? Probably a little bit roomy, I would have thought. See, let me bring it back first. Okay, so despite the fact that all video mics have this incredibly handy cold shoe mount on the bottom, which makes it very tempting to just stick them on top of our DSLRs and leave them there, one of the best, most awesome things about video mics is because they are a separate system, we can move them away from the camera. We can move them closer to the subject that we want to record. Never assume that where the camera is necessarily the best place to put the microphone. And one of the inexpensive accessories that RØDE sell is this thing called a VC1. This is a extension cable. It's a 3 meter extension cable, and I'm running a VC1 from our camera to our VideoMic Pro just in front. This thing allows you to take the microphone off the camera and get it closer to the subject. These can also be placed on tripods. So just like mine, I have it on a tripod. You can get it, put it on a table, just very close. We also have boom poles, and these things screw right into the bottom of the boom pole. So you literally can, at like in a twist, turn this into a portable system. It's just a question of reducing the amount of reflected ambient sound that we're picking up and just maximizing the amount of direct sound straight from the person's mouth, which is what's going to make it sound dry and clear and professional, because it's just so much better if you can get it closer. So this leads us on to talking about levels in your camera, and obviously the way that you set that up is going to vary depending on the model that you have. A lot of consumer cameras have their default level setting set to auto, which is where the camera is going to automatically manage those levels for us. This is almost uniformly dreadful. Never, ever, ever, ever leave this on, because it will actually ruin a lot of the great stuff that your video mic will be doing for the audio, because it's going to be changing the levels without our permission. So turn it off, get the mic as close as you possibly can, and setting the levels manually, because there'll be a little menu setting to adjust the levels, ask your speaking subject to speak, just to give you a bit of level, ask them to do a bit of speaking at the level that they're going to do, and just adjust it so that you're kind of nicely hitting yellow, not going into red. You want to hit about minus 12 dB if your meters have that, which will give you a good level, not too quiet, not too loud. So that's enough technique. Let's look at some microphones. And first up, we're going to check out the lovely directional mono video mics. Okay, so first up, we have the RØDE VideoMic Go, which is the simplest, least expensive of all of the video mics. It has no controls at all. You literally just plug it in and go. Doesn't need a battery. So if you're working very casually, you're just starting out and you're on a mega budget, this thing is totally awesome for getting way better sound in your DSLR than what is already inbuilt. And it's about £55 and it's got a 2-year warranty. Okay, next up you've got the original video mic. So it's slightly more directional. It does take a 9-volt battery. Inside we have the ability to pad the microphone down so that we can record very loud sources. We have the ability to engage a high pass filter if we want it, or to leave it off so that we have the option of recording nice fuller bassy sounding things. Slightly larger, but slightly more control. This is about £75, and when you register it, you get a 10-year warranty. Okay, and then lastly, we have the VideoMic Pro. So very small and neat, with an elasticated shot mount system. It also has a high pass filter on the back if we want to engage that. But critically, the VideoMic Pro has the ability to engage the 20 dB boost mode. So if we want to record the cleanest, most professional sounding audio on a DSLR in mono, this is the one to get. This is about £139, and again, if we register it, we get a 10-year warranty. Let's check out the awesome ambient stereo mics. We've got the stereo video mic. It's all cast aluminium, very, very tough. Has a pad to cope with loud sources, a high pass to take out rumble, runs on a 9-volt battery, and we get a dead kitten furry wind cover with it. About £114.99, has a 10-year warranty. Okay, so then we have the Stereo VideoMic Pro, and of course this is smaller and it's lighter, and it critically has the 20 dB boost mode. So if we want to have really clean sounding recordings on a DSLR, then this will give us that. And it's got a 10-year warranty and it's £149. Okay, and then lastly, you have Stereo VideoMic X, and this thing just has insanely high build quality, and it has studio-grade capsules with Rycote Lyre shock mounting built into each one, a ton of controls on the back. It can be powered off of a 9-volt battery, but it obviously also supports the ability to be phantom powered or to connect to very high quality XLR input devices using a separately available cable. Of course, just like the others, we can stick it right onto our cameras, very convenient to use, and included are the foam windshield and a furry cover, and you get the SC3 cable as well. Of course, it has a 10-year warranty if you register it, and the price is around £619. And remembering that the most important thing we can possibly do is get the microphone close, let's check out some accessories to do just that. We're going to need to take the mic off and extend the 3.5mm cable that is on the end of it. To do this, one absolutely essential accessory is this thing called a VC1, and it is just simply a 3-meter extension cable made by RØDE. And what you do is you just plug the end of your video mic into that, and then the other end of this runs all the way into the side of your camera. Once you've done that, you're going to be free to be able to move your microphone in a 3-meter radius around your camera. And the most obvious thing to do is to put the microphone on something. To help with this, I would totally recommend picking up one of these things, which is called a tripod, as in it's a RØDE tripod. And the tripod will screw right into the bottom of the video mic. You have this neat little head that can angle and adjust so that you can tilt the video mic. And what's nice here is this can be placed on a surface just out of shot. And there's a neat little trick with the tripod. I discovered this relatively recently, which is that the base unscrews. This little head can be screwed onto the end of a traditional studio mic stand. And that means that you can actually place the video mic high up on a mic stand, using the mic stand kind of like a boom. Obviously, the alternative is to get an actual boom, and there is a boom pole which is called the micro boom pole, which is about $29.99. This is a 2-meter telescoping boom pole, and what's awesome about this is that the capacity to be put on this is built into every video mic. You see here on the bottom of the mic we have a little thread, and you literally just screw this in, and we then have the ability to boom the mic. Totally awesome. So if we're recording an interview with two people, you can move from side to side wielding the boom, or you can just move it just underneath and out of frame. And of course this thing twists and unlocks, can be extended to 2 meters long. So it's really, really useful. Not an expensive accessory, but what it allows us to do, the VC1 and the boom pole or a tripod, is to just get the mic closer to the speaking subject in a really easy way. Please make sure you consider some of these, because this is just awesome to be able to do. So if you're going to be shooting outside for any amount of time whatsoever, you need to have a furry wind cover adding an extra layer of protection for the VideoMic capsule. Some of the video mics that we're looking at actually already include a furry wind cover, and with some of them it's an optional extra. I'm going to take you outside now and show you the difference that a furry wind cover makes. It's a really important accessory, so if you want to film outside and your mic doesn't already include one, please make sure you pick one up as well. this is the stereo video mic, and we've got a dead kitten on it. A little bit of wind. Let me take it off. Bear with it on. So that's the whole video mic range and everything that you'd need to get up close personal sound out of your DSLR. It's a lot to take in, we understand. So what we've done is we've created a special web page which lists all of the products that we've talked about, and it suggests some bundles that will work really well together. So look for that link in the description below. So please check out that link, comment and subscribe. If you have any questions, please ask a question. And most importantly, please go out and make a video that sounds awesome. Thanks.